Hi, welcome to Silkatronic. I had a request to go over my WARBL configuration, particularly as it applies to the new wind synth Respiro. And I'm going to be doing this on the iPad with the Respiro Player app. One of the nice things about the iPad is that you can use the WARBL configuration tool at the same time as a synth app. So you can kind of see what effect your changes have on the app while you're playing. If you try this on the PC, you have to switch back and forth because it won't share the MIDI connection. But let's go ahead and dive into it. So here you see the WARBL configuration tool. And as you can see, my primary instrument is the Native American flute fingering mode. My C instrument is actually an ANAF for reasons I won't go into here. But as you can see, let me go ahead and switch over to Respiro, and you can see I've got the stock patch clarinetish dialed up. So as you can see there, I get a lot of dynamics and control over the sound. Now, switch back to WARBL and we can see where that's coming from. So first of all, down here in the expression section, you have to have the send pressure as CC and CC2. That's very important for wind controller use. Optionally, you can send pressure as velocity, which I usually do, and send pressure as aftertouch, which I should probably not have on. Yeah, so that's just extra extra messaging for Respiro that's not needed. Other wind synths or synth apps don't listen to breath, the CC2, but they do listen to aftertouch, and you can use that for those. Okay, so you want send expression, you want send pressure. Optionally, send pressure as velocity. I think that really doesn't matter for Respiro. Okay, and then the breath curve is important. Now, you can use this to taste with linear, curve 2, or curve 3. I'll try and show, so you can see my baseline set up here is with linear. And let's see if we can hear the difference. So you can kind of hear with curve 3, you jump higher, quicker. Curve 2 is a little bit lower. Curve and linear. And I usually like the linear, just feels more controllable to me. Now for input and output range. So input pressure range, you can see I have it cut way down. And if you look over here on the right in the pressure readout, you can get a readout of how hard I'm blowing. So you can see if you really blow hard, you can get way up into the 20 range. I find for a comfortable pressure is way lower than that. So here's kind of my top pressure. You can see it tops out around 8 or so. So that's why I've got my input pressure way on the low side, because that's really the about all the range that I typically use. Output range, I want full range. So what that means is that maps my 0 to 8-ish range in pressure to the full expression range. And that's important to me because let me switch back over to Respiro. So now as I go from no breath up to that 8-ish range, I get a full control over the sound. So you can see I have pretty much full control over the dynamic range in Respiro. So that's why I set up my expression curve that particular way. Now, some other things here. Everything else is kind of personal preference. So vibrato and slide, you can see here finger sensing distance. That's basically how far your finger has to be above the note, or you know, close to how close your finger has to be to sound a note. And that kind of middle position feels good to me for kind of the trade-off between speed and glitching, if you will. So if you get it too close, then you'll get glitches. If you get too far, then you don't get the speed. So you just have to play around with that to find your happy medium. Vibrato depth, again, that's personal preference. I have 13. If I go blast that way up, and put that back down. And the exact setting there is probably not critical. There we go. I do have slide and vibrato, so I can slide into a note. As well as the vibrato. And I have vibrato on everything except for the thumb. Note trigger and register control. So I have it set up for thumb register. So when I release the thumb, I get the upper octave. You can choose overblow. A lot of whistle players will do overblow. So let's quickly switch over to the whistle instrument. Now, this setup is not exactly like Andrew's. I'll give you a link below to Andrew's setup for Respiro. And if you're used to more of a whistle response or a bagpipe-like response, this might work better for you. But you can see my input is the same. Output range is way on the high side. And watch what that does. Okay, so I'm sure I don't have my note trigger set up the same way Andrew does, but what that does is you're really, let's switch back over to Respiro. What you can see that forces your breath control way up on the high side, and you kind of lose control for your expression. So that's basically why I don't like that mode. Now, it works for Andrew. His setup was obviously responding better in his video than mine is. But so that's why I have mine set up the way I do. Okay, so there you go, some choices, and you can choose which one fits your playing style. And great thing about the WARBL is it is completely configurable, and you can set it up to get it to respond to your particular playing style, your particular breath pressure, fingering mode, all that. So yeah, check it out. And if you have any questions, let me know. I'll try to get those answered for you. Thanks.